same method on a blouse. You can use the same method on the skirt. This is how I sew my zip, and it's what I'm going to show you now. I'm using this type of zip because they are a bit more stronger. It's the open end zip. It's what I'm using, and I'm going to be using my industrial zipper foot, or open toe. One side of it is open. There is a left and a right. I normally use this when I want to sew a zip or when I'm sewing a fabric with a lot of stones and beads. It's very good. So I use this. It's normally called a zipper foot for industrial machine, not for domestic machine. How to sew a zipper the easiest way. As to say, this is the easiest way to sew a zip in case you are struggling. So sew a zip onto your dress, your blouse, your skirt, trouser. I'll show you how to do the trouser one on another video. This one, you can use this one for your dress, skirt, blouse. So remember, this is the zip allowance. So what I do is I open it out. You can iron it. If your iron is close by, make sure your iron is very important. Iron, trim, and I will overlock the edge later on to make it more neater. So I take the zip. This is the front of the zip, that's the puller. So what I do is I take the front right side of the zip, I face it down. I face it down to the right side of the fabric. See that? So I unzip it. I unzip just a little bit half down. So I take this, I see the point here. The zip stopper, the zipper, the puller, the thing that stops it from coming out. I take it, I put it here at the very end of the fabric. You can pin here if you want to. Because I'm used to doing it, sometimes I don't pin it. But for those who are learning to do it, it's best to pin it. It's easier that way. So you pin it sideways so you can easily remove the pin. See? You can pin it. Now I'm going to sew it. That's why I like to use this foot. Done. then you remove the pin. If not, your machine needle is going to break. So when I'm sewing, as I sew along, I'll be unzipping it until I get to the point I want to stop. I'm just going to cross-check the zip to make sure it's long enough to the point I want to stop. Make sure your zip is long enough. This is a dress, so you need a long zip for a dress. So I'm just going to stitch now. So before I start, I lift, you can see that I lift the zip. This is a zip allowance. I separate it like this. So this is the other side of the back. So you have to separate the zip allowance away from this side. Don't sew it on top. If you sew it on top, it's not going to come out okay. So you have to separate them and let the zip allowance stay on its own. Stop here. I'm going to stop just about here. I think that is long enough. Side, what I do sometimes I change the zipper foot to the other side. Sometimes I used this side. So what you can do, if you only have just this one, if you don't have the other one, because you have a left and right, one here, this foot here is the right foot. In case you don't have the left foot, this is what I do. If I don't have the left foot, I still stick to using this right foot. So all I do is, as I say, don't stitch it down like this. Don't stitch it here down like this. Don't stitch it down. Separate it. So what I do is I stick to this foot still. The right foot, and then I just top stitch here first to hold the zip together, to hold the zip together with the fabric. When I finish, I turn it to the other side and I sew it proper. For this, I'm just attaching the zip like this first because I'm not using the other foot. Sew it like this first. And then I open it out. I'm going to use my seam ripper to to open it out so you can see the zip. I'll just get my seam ripper. So this is my seam ripper. I'm just going to rip it, open it. Just take a seam ripper or your razor blade if you don't have a seam ripper. Yeah, using a seam ripper, be careful because you don't want to. To rip the cloth, you don't want to cut it, so you have to be careful. I'm just using my seam ripper. I'm sewing at home, guys. I'm sewing in my kitchen. Pardon the background. Okay, so once you've loosened it to the point where you stop stitching, okay, seam ripper, it's very good. Show you the next stage, what to do next. Okay, so once you've opened it out, you can see the zip. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to unzip it a little bit, just unzip it a bit. practically sip it all the way down to the point where you stop sewing it. So you see the zip, you take it and you fold it down, fold the zip down facing the armhole section. See the zip, and then you bend here, take the, this part of the zip, you just fold it, fold it to the back, and then you turn it. When you turn it, now you can stitch the zip. The excess fabric here is going to hide the zip. Again, the top of the zip. Now this is a zip allowance over here. You see, I've opened it flat. So what I'm going to do now is this top of the zip, I push it to the back of the dress, and then I fold in the zip allowance to the back. This one, make sure you put it down properly and fold the zip allowance to the back. So it's like this. So I'm going to top stitch it. So I just stitch all the way down. So when you get to this point, you're going to do a little back stitch there, little back stitch here, and then you're going to sew the other side of the zip. Just top stitch it. Quite hard and breaks the thread. Get here, you do the same thing, fold it in, and you turn it. Now I'm going to join the back to the front. I'll just show you how does it look like. Okay, I'm going to stitch the back to the front now.